Hi Kong, thank you for the time to pick up the call. Sana matapos na po, puro na lang allegation. Pag-pray ko din po, maging fair enough. Din po, I'm not involved in politics and will not po. Ayoko din pong madamay sa away po ng malalaking tao. Mabuhay po ang Pilipinas, mabuhay si PBBM. This is not special. Hindi po kayo lamang ang resource person that we are investigating. We hope you understand and you're asking for 10 minutes for us to wait another 10 minutes. I think, Mr. Chair, that is unacceptable.
Congressman Apo, preparing to. I am one of the chairman of the court committee.
Yes, 1 minute suspension.
And I have the right.
1 minute.
And recognize Congresswoman Jenky Luistro. You're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, we are in possession of the letter of Attorney Harry Roque seeking for excuse for his absence in today's committee hearing. Considering, Mr. Chair, that we have precedent already where the resource speaker misrepresented as to the truthfulness of the fact of the schedule of his hearing, may I move, Mr. Chair, that the veracity of the truthfulness of the facts cited in this letter be verified by the committee secretary. So move, Mr. Chair.
There is a motion for the committee secretary to verify information as stipulated in the letter of Attorney Harry Roque. Duly seconded and hearing no objection, the motion is approved. Comsec, please comply.
Second, Mr. Chair, in our last lengthy hearing, Attorney Harry Roque repeatedly made representation of his commitment to submit a number of documents that includes his SALN from 2016 to 2022, DOS of multinational subdivision with tax returns, trust agreement, settlement of estate and tax returns, docs submitted to SEC pertaining to the transfer of shareholdings from spouses Roque to attorney Percival Ortega, and ultimately the ITR of spouses Roque and Biancham Corporation. I lament, Mr. Speaker, that while we waited for the submission of these documents, because of his assurance and commitment that he will be forwarding the same, to this date, we have not received any of those, granting only for the sake of discussion that indeed he has engagements in the international arbitration in Singapore today. I do not see any reason why he will fail to submit those documents in today's hearing. Nonetheless, Mr. Chair, I understand that the committee has issued already a subpoena as earlier manifested in our morning session. I therefore manifest instead this reasonable warning for our resource speaker to comply with the said subpoena.
The statement of Congresswoman Luistro is noted, and the Comsec is directed to follow up the requests of Congresswoman Luistro pertaining to the documents required of Attorney Harry Roque. Thank you, Congresswoman Luistro.
Third, Mr. Chair, the committee is in receipt of the letter from Cassandra Leong, represented by Attorney Tupaso, claiming, among others, that her client opted to decline to testify, invoking the right to remain silent and or the right against self-incrimination. I deeply lament this action coming from the resource speaker, Mr. Chair, because we will remember that even prior to the creation of the Quadcom, various resource speakers have been mentioning already the name of Cassandra Leong. And it is really unacceptable if we will allow in today's hearing that the resource speaker will remain silent, will not answer our questions under the guise of his right against self-incrimination. In the same letter, Mr. Chair, they even cited the case of violation of visa law of the Bureau of Immigration, as well as obstruction of justice, as the case is filed already against the resource speaker, making an impression, Mr. Chair, that we cannot raise question to her anymore. With that, Mr. Chair, please allow this representation to lay down the parameters when the right against self-incrimination may be availed and when they may not be availed. Mr. Chair?
Please proceed.
In the case of Rosete versus Lim, this was decided June 8, 2006. There are two requirements before the right to self-incrimination may be availed. One, there must be an identifiable crime. And two, the resource speaker is probably guilty of the said crime. Second, Mr. Chair, in the case of Sabio versus Gordon, October 17, 2006, right to self-incrimination can be availed only when the same is being invoked in relation to the question which is being propounded. In other words, this cannot be claimed as a blanket privilege. When there is a question, the resource speaker has to invoke and the chair has to resolve. Third, Mr. Chair, the case of De La Cruz versus People, July 23, 2014. The right to self-incrimination applies only to testimonial compulsion. In other words, object evidence is not covered by the right against self-incrimination. Fourth, Mr. Chair, is the Office of the Court Administrator versus you, which pronounces it does not cover legitimate inquiry if non-criminal matters. In other words, only question which pertain to crimes is covered by the right against self-incrimination. Fifth, Mr. Chair, is the case of People versus Ison, July 1989. The right to self-incrimination is not self-executing or automatically operational. In other words, it needs to be invoked. Otherwise, it is considered waived. Sixth, Mr. Chair, is the case of Arnold versus Nazareno. It was ruled that the right cannot be invoked if the same would be inconsistent to the witness prior claim that the transaction were legal. If there is a prior statement already that the transaction is legal, all the subsequent questions pertaining to the same are not covered anymore by the right against self-incrimination. And last, Mr. Chair, the case of People versus Gonzo, which is likewise the ruling in the case of Senate versus Ermita. A witness is not relieved from answering merely on his own declaration that an answer might incriminate him, but rather it is for the trial judge to decide. By analogy, Mr. Chair, in our today's inquiry in aid of legislation, the discretion belongs to the chair of the Quad Committee. Mr. Chair, to proceed with my interpellation.
Please proceed.
Mr. Chair. Chairman Paduano.
Sige, Chairman Paduano.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for the indulgence of Congresswoman Luistro. First, Mr. Chairman, I'll discuss in more some administrative matters. No? Maybe we can discuss this, especially in the case of Myla Roque and Harry Roque. But Mr. Chairman, just a procedural thing. I think there are counsels for Baterna and Casiong in the person of, I've seen Attorney Topacio. Is Attorney Topacio present? Yeah, you should have make an official entry, no, as the counsel of Casandoong. And at the same time, just to remind all the counsel that you cannot speak or advise your client unless you will be allowed by the chairman. That's all, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano. Let me remind the counsel of Ms. Cassandra Leong, Attorney Topacio, that the participation of the counsel in the inquiry in aid of legislation is limited only to advising the legal rights of his client. And that goes the same to other counsel appearing before this committee. Thank you. We shall now proceed.
Mr. Chair, I wish to address these questions to Cassandra Leong.
Excuse me, Congresswoman Luistro. I'm sorry, but I missed the lineup of the members who wish to interpellate. I have it here with me now, and the first to interpellate is Congressman Dan Fernandez, and then after Dan Fernandez, Congresswoman Jinky Luistro, and then Congressman Rog Gutierrez, and then Congressman Deputy Speaker Frasco, and then Congressman Gaston Bunting. So please proceed, Congressman Dan Fernandez.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman. Cassandra, Cassie, kumusta ka na? Can you kindly remove your face mask?
Paige, can you please?
Maganda ka naman eh. Huwag ka nang... relax ka lang, Cassandra. The reason why we invited you over, because if you remember, during the joint committee hearing, we invited you twice. And then you never acceded to the invitation of the joint committee hearing, and then we issued a subpoena, and then we elevated this issue on the Quadcom. You remember the time that you texted me, diba? And eventually you call me. And the reason why I'm trying to tell this, Mr. Chair, during the time that we have conducted that committee hearing, that joint committee hearing, Cassandra, in the spirit of transparency, you know, Cassandra, no, I will tell the body, you know, that you texted me and you called me, para at least malaman nila kung saan tayo magsisimula. But the reason why you called me is to ask for help. Kung ano yung dapat mong gawin. Am I right? You can answer.
Yes po.
Yes, at during our conversation, sinabi mo kung ano yung dapat mong gawin. Is this correct, Cassandra?
Yes po.
All right. And sa text mo sa akin, no? And I know that this came from your heart, no? Sinabi mo dito sa text mo na, "Hi Kong, thank you for the time to pick up the call. Sana matapos na po, puro na lang allegation. Pag-pray ko din po, maging fair enough din po. I'm not involved in politics and will not po. Ayoko din pong madamay sa away po ng malalaking tao. Mabuhay po ang Pilipinas, mabuhay si PBBM." So you texted this, di ba? You remember? And you were saying na ayaw mo rin may madamay na sa away ng malalaking tao. Are you referring to sino personality are you trying to imply on your text?
I invoke my right to remain silent po.
I invoke my right.
Yes po.
To your ano, to your right. Okay, so
I'm advising her to answer.
Kasi simple lang naman tinatanong ko kung sino yung mga ano to, malalaking tao ba ng mga Chinese o malalaking tao ng mga Pilipino? Mga politician ba ang sinasabi mong ayaw mo ma-involve sa away ng malalaking tao? You can answer directly, no? I mean, there's nothing wrong on saying, kasi sabi mo Pilipino ka, di ba? And I will show you, Cassandra, this is the certificate of your naturalization nung papa mo. And we were able to get that during the time of 1978, he applied for the naturalization. And thereby, when you born in year 2000, you are a Pilipina, di ba? So, Pilipina ka. So, maaring sa dugo ay Chinese ka, pero sa puso at isipan, Pilipina ka. Am I correct?
Opo.
At saan ka madadamay ng mga away na sinasabi mo sa text mo sa akin? I never replied, di ba? Hindi ako nag-reply sa'yo eh. Because I really don't want you to answer back on my cell phone. What I wanted is for you to appear on the committee and to answer to all of us. So, sino?
Mr. Chair, I invoke my right po to remain silent po.
Congressman Fernandez, if
yes,
I may.
Mr. Chair.
Yung tanong ni Congressman Dan Fernandez ay hindi naman incriminating. Dahil ang tanong niya, kaninong away? Is that an incriminating statement?
Ang sinasabi ko po is right to remain silent po. Hindi po self-incrimination.
Mr. Chair?
Okay. Congressman Akop?
I would just like to remind Madam Cassandra Ong and her lawyer that what we are conducting here is not a custodial investigation where you can invoke your right to remain silent. There have been Supreme Court decisions on this. So I think the witness has to answer. Otherwise, we will move to citing contempt for refusal to answer.
Mr. Chairman,
That is correct. Congressman Aluistro, you want to...
Mr. Chair, the reason why I started our hearing with the parameters on the use of right to self-incrimination is to guide our resource speaker as to when they can be availed of and when they cannot. And as far as this representation is concerned, Mr. Chair, we have two elements before they can avail of the right against self-incrimination. One, there must be identifiable crime. And two, there is the probability that the resource speaker may be convicted of the crime. Now at this point, Mr. Chair, may we ask Ms. Cassandra Ong, nung tinanong ka ba ni Honorable Dan Fernandez, kaninong away ang iniiwasan mo? Ano bang krimen ang iniisip mo na baka ikaw ay madamay?
I refuse to answer po para sa own reason ko po.
If I may, Congressman Luistro, I'm sure it is upon the advice of your counsel, Attorney Topacio. Kaya mo sinasabi that you refuse to testify or the right against self-incrimination, etc., etc. Pero maliwanag po na marami pong sinight ng mga jurisprudence tungkol dito. And we are very lenient to your client, Attorney Topacio. And because of that leniency, we allowed her to appear before us so that we can propound questions related to the alleged crime that she has committed. Under the jurisprudence that was cited by Congresswoman Luistro, meron pong identifiable crime. And we don't want the committee to be compelled to cite her in contempt. Because as it is, she is already detained in the House. And once the committee rules on citing her in contempt again, she probably would stay in this detention facility much longer. Kaya please, advise your client to cooperate. As long as her rights are not violated, we will continue to ask her questions. At yung mga tanong po na yan ay related po sa investigasyon na kung saan ay mayroon pong operasyon ng illegal na pogo dito sa ating bansa at si Cassandra Leong ang mukha o ang representasyon o representative nitong mga pogong ito. Kaya yun ang gusto po naming malaman, Attorney Topacio. Please, advise your client. Yes, Cassandra, naintindihan mo ba yung sinabi ko?
Yes po.
So, okay. Sasagot ka na, Cassandra.
Mr. Chair, pwede po ako mag-excuse sa sarili ko ng like 10 minutes lang po.
Excused for 10 minutes?
To consult
with your lawyer?
Mm.
10 minutes?
Yes po.
The chair, is that too long? I mean, that's too long.
5 minutes.
You can consult any member you wish to consult. Kung yan ang problema. Kasi if you give you 10 minutes, alam mo, kanina pang umaga, itong ating mga resource persons naghihintay.
Yeah.
In fact, we started 10 o'clock, tuloy-tuloy po, at wag mo nang i-delay. Simple lang naman po yung tanong. Yung tanong po ay related po doon sa iyong involvement dyan sa Lucky South 99.
And Mr. Chairman, I think the resource person must consider na, well, she's not special. Hindi po kayo lamang ang resource person that we are investigating. All of these resource persons have been here since morning. Lucky you are in your own room, di ba? Meron kang aircon, meron kang sariling kwarto. But all of these people who are working tirelessly to parrot the truth, has been here for so long. We hope you understand that you're asking for 10 minutes for us to wait another 10 minutes. I think, Mr. Chair, that is unacceptable. And if I may can we ask Attorney Topacio?
Yes, sir, you may.
What's the reason, Attorney Topacio, that you are asking for a 10-minute suspension?
May I address the chair, Your Honor?
Yes, please.
It was not my idea, actually, Your Honor. It was her request to me. And I told her to relay it directly because I cannot talk unless recognized. Thank you, Your Honors.
Thank you, Attorney Topacio. Congressman Fernandez, please proceed.
Cassandra, what is the reason for your 5-minute suspension that for you to talk to your lawyer? Are you asking for a 10-minute...
Yes, po. Yes, po.
And what's the reason behind?
Mr. Chair.
Okay, sige. We will allow you for a 5-minute conference with your lawyer, provided that pagbalik mo, you will tell the truth. Is that clear?
Mr. Chairman, I object. Because we've been waiting here for so long. Let's start with this now.
I think the resource person needs to confer with her client. And... The committee is interested about that, and because it is also her right,
Mr. Chair.
We can provide her at least 5 minutes.
Mr. Chair, may I remind our members that when the chair is speaking, let us not disturb him. That is the rule.
Thank you, Congressman
Acop. Thank you also, Congressman Abante.
Well, so, Mr. Chair, I'd like to find out who is Congressman Acop referring to. I am one of the chairman of the court committee.
Yes, 1 minute to speak.
I have the right.
1 minute.
Punta sila nag-away. Busy.
Hearing is resumed. You already had your 5 minutes, Cassandra. So, please proceed, Congressman Dan.
Okay, I hope, Cassie, no, you'll be answering all the query of all these members who are here. Precisely because you are a Pilipina. Pilipina ka. And I just want you to remind you, no? I'll show you some pictures, no, Cassandra. Have you seen this? Nakita mo na ba to? These are all the torture victims na nakuha sa cellphone doon sa Porac at sa Banban. All those collected cellphones ay nakalagay itong mga pictures na to. These are victims of torture perpetrated doon sa Porac at sa Banban. Have you seen this? No, first time. Now lang? Okay. I will show you another picture. Ito mga pictures din. At tinan mo yung mga namatay. They are 66 foreigners. Hindi makilala kung bakit sila namatay. Lahat sila, almost all Chinese. Natagpuan sila, almost everybody sa Region 3. So, nakita mo na ba sila? Hindi pa? Hindi pa rin?
Hindi po.
Okay. The reason why I showed you all these pictures is for you to realize the gravity of what you are into right now. Are you a incorporator of Lucky South 99?
Hindi po.
Hindi ka incorporator ng Lucky South 99? Never? Remember, you are under oath. Member ka or not? Baka ina-advise mo, attorney, mali. Ha? Starting 2019, she is already an executive assistant of Lucky South 99. Cassandra, are you an incorporator of Lucky South 1999 since 2019 to the present?
I think assistant lang po, pero hindi siya incorporator.
You are an executive assistant?
Tag po dito, authority.
2019. Tama, Cassandra? Okay. Kailan ka naging executive assistant ng Lucky South 99? Kung pagbabasihan natin yung mga dokumento, November 2019, incorporated ka na doon. And you were like 19 years old during that time. Am I correct? Correct?
Yes po.
19 years old.
19 years old.
Paano ka nakapagtrabaho sa Lucky South 99?
Mr. Chair, I refuse to answer.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair, point of order.
Point of order.
Well, what is the point of order of
the... Mr. Chair, I'm getting confused. With all due respect to Attorney Topacio, every time Chairman Dan gives a question, it seems that it's Attorney Topacio answering. So I think we should. No, I've been watching you, and you've been whispering. So can we please give the resource person the opportunity to answer truthfully?
Attorney Topacio, may we ask you to refrain from answering in behalf of your client? As we clearly stated earlier, the role of the counsel is only limited to advising your client of his or her constitutional rights in this committee hearing. So Cassie, ikaw ang sumagot. Okay.
Yes. Thank Attorney you. Topacio, with all due respect, I mean, I don't mean no offense to you, but it's just that let's allow the resource person the freedom to explain her side and to you know, explain how she's involved or not involved in this situation, because this is her opportunity to clear her name. Thank you very much, Mr. Chair.
Okay, kasi sino nag-recruit sa'yo sa Lucky South 99?
I refuse to testify po.
Okay, yun ang una mong, no? Yun ang una mong trabaho sa Lucky South 99?
I refuse to testify po, sorry, Mr. Chair.
Tinatanong ko lang kung ano yun ang unang mong trabaho. Pwede mo naman sabihin iba ang trabaho mo, di ba? Anong unang trabaho mo sa buhay mo?
Pasensya na po ulit. I refuse to testify po.
Saan ka nag-college? This will not incriminate you.
It will po.
What? Ang tinatanong ko, saan ka nag-college?
I refuse to.
Sabi mo, Pilipina ka, di ba? Did you study in the Philippines?
I refuse po to testify po.
Attorney Topacio, let this be a warning to you to please allow your client to respond to the question. We will, you know, these are simple questions. Tinanong lang, saan siya nag-aral, saan siya nag-college? Right against self-incrimination? Please. This is a warning, Attorney Topacio. Let her answer. Kasi,
Mr. Chair,
ano mo lang, sagot mo lang ng tama ito. Dahil yung tanong na kung saan ka nag-aral ay hindi naman incriminating sa'yo. Bakit refuse to answer? Pagpipilitan kami, i-contempt ka.
Mr. Chairman, parang yes, yung sa paper ni Cassandra, pero nakagad sagot na pinuturo ni Attorney Topacio eh. Diba? So I will give you another chance, Attorney Topacio. Mr. Chairman.
Please proceed, Congressman Fernandez.
Okay, I'll be asking Ronaldine Batiana. Ronaldine Batiana, in the last hearing you were testifying, no? During that time, you told us that you have a checking account. And this checking account, yung checking account na pinirmahan mo, sinabi mo binigay mo kay Cassandra, di ba? At yung milyong-milyong piso na dumaan doon sa checking account, sabi mo, ibinigay mo kay Cassie. Is this correct?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So Cassie, ang sabi ni Ronaldine Batiana, who happens to be in the Lucky South 99 and in the Willwind Corporation, binigay niya yung mga cheque sa'yo. At maraming milyon-milyon ang dumaan pera dito. So, ginamit mo yung checking account.
Pasensya na po talaga. I refuse to testify po.
Mr. Chair.
We'll change na lang the question. If she feels that it will incriminate her.
We will be... Congressman Fernandez. Yes, is this a short interjection?
Mr. Chair.
Please proceed.
I move to cite Cassandra in contempt.
Second.
There is a motion to cite Cassandra Ong in contempt for
Mr. Chairman
violation of Section 11, Paragraph A and C of the Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation. Duly seconded. Do I hear any objections?
Mr. Chair. Apologies, Mr. Chair. This is not an objection, but just a manifestation. In the spirit of due process, may we ask that the witness explain why she should not be cited in contempt. If she has any reason,
we'll give her that privilege.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair.
Chairman,
picture 3. Picture 3.
Chairman, just a point of clarification.
Okay. Congressman Paduano.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, before we rule with the motion that was made by Chairman Co-Chair Abante, kasi there's a contempt order now for Ms. Cassandra Ong, in which her violation is refusal to be present in the previous hearing until he was cited in contempt, Mr. Chairman. Now, what will happen to that first contempt order of this committee, Mr. Chairman? So, dalawang contempt? This is the first.
The motion made by Congressman Abante has not been ruled yet.
Yeah, that's why.
Because there was an interjection by Congressman Gutierrez, and then the chair acknowledged, recognized Congressman Paduano for your interjection as well. So there's no decision yet as to the motion to cite her in contempt. Now, if there are no other obstructions, can we now rule on the motion?
Mr. Chairman.
Oh, yes, please.
What will be the proper position with regards to my query? That this is the first time in the history, in my 11 years in Congress, for those cited in contempt, two contempt orders.
Mr.
And
Chair,
I'm just checking the process and our internal rules. I will never object, Mr. Chairman, but what I'm saying is, we have already issued a contempt order for Cassandra Ong. Now, if we will approve that motion by Congressman Chairman Abante, sabi ko nga, this will be the first time that a resource person was...
Mr. Chairman, game mo for 1 minute suspension?
Yes. 1 minute suspension. Hearing is resumed. Okay, earlier, the parliamentary status is that there is a motion to cite Cassandra Ong in contempt for the second time for violating Section 11, Paragraph A and Paragraph C of the rules. Paragraph C of the rules of the House. And in the spirit of fairness, we would like to give her the opportunity to answer. Manifested and stated by Congressman Gutierrez, so I will now allow Congressman Gutierrez to direct your questions to Cassandra Leong with a warning to the Council that your appearance again is only limited to advising the legal rights of your client. And under the same rules of the House, we can also ask you to be cited in contempt and removed from this room if you continue to disobey the warning of the chair. So again, I'd like to make, I'd like to ask the counsel, Attorney Topacio, do you understand the ruling of the chair?
Yes, Your Honor, I'm only advising her, Your Honor.
Make sure that you only advise your client. Otherwise, we will be compelled to remove you out of this room and assign another lawyer for today's hearing for our witness, Ms. Cassandra Ong.
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you. Maraming salamat. Please proceed, okay. Congressman Roger Gutierrez.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, I raised that point earlier because precisely I agree with the manifestation of Congresswoman Luistro that regarding the right, invocation of the right to remain silent or right against self-incrimination is not absolute. Again, this is not a court of justice. However, given that we give deference to this right and we protect it, it must still follow the process, the due process provisions and rights that she may have. Given that, Mr. Chair, just to clarify, po, when the right of against self-incrimination is invoked, first, there must be a specific identifiable crime, and second, that the witness is the one who probably committed the crime. To repeat the question po, saan ka po nag-college? Now, Ms. Ong, through the chair, most respectfully, kindly justify your refusal to answer that question.
Again po, Mr. Chair, I refuse to answer or to testify po.
Then, Mr. Chair, I think the witness has chosen not to defend the question, and I believe the proper thing now is for the chairman to rule on the propriety of the invocation of the right against self-incrimination, and from there, I suppose, we would then vote on the contempt. Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Thank you, Madam Ong.
Thank you, Congressman Gutierrez.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Congressman Ako.
May I ask the resource person to repeat her answer to the query of the Honorable Gutierrez? I refuse to testify ba? Ang sagot po ninyo? Ha?
Testify po.
You refuse to testify. Yun po ang kasagutan ninyo doon sa katanungan po ni Honorable Gutierrez. So you refuse to testify. In other words, hindi ka na sasagot?
Opo.
Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Just a intermin to that. Just an observation. Just an observation po, Mr. Chair. Prior to, after the motion was raised, citing her in contempt, Congressman Roger Gutierrez asked the chair to allow the witness to explain to the body why she's refusing to answer. Now, Ms. Ong, ang sinasabi lang po ni Congressman Roger, bibigyan ka ng pagkakataon, explain sa amin kung bakit mo nire-refuse yung mga simpleng tanong. Tulad ng saan ka nag-college na hindi naman ho talaga siya incriminating. So yun lang ho yung binibigay sa'yo para maintindihan ho namin kung bakit ayaw mong sumagot. Binibigyan ka namin ng pagkakataon, i-explain po sa amin kung bakit ganyan yung asta mo na ayaw mong sagutin. Maski yung mga simpleng bagay like pag tinanong kita, anong favorite color mo, sabihin mo, I refuse to testify. So bakit ho ganun yung inyong asta ngayon?
Marami pong reason. Una, under oath po ako dito. And possible po siya magamit against me in the future po.
Mr. Chair, if I may.
Mr. Chair.
The lady, Ms. Catherine Leong, refused to answer. No? May I be allowed to ask the documents that they filed in PAGCOR to prove? No? Oh, I'm sorry. So we still have a motion.
Mr. Chair.
There is. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm just waiting
okay,
for the members to...
Mr. Chair.
Is this related to the motion?
Yes, I just would like to say that we have spent too much time with one witness. So therefore, the motion has been said and there is a second to it. So Mr. Chair, please make a ruling now.
Okay, thank you for saying that.
Parliamentary inquiry, Mr. Chair, since Ms. Cassandra Leong is already detained in the House, this second contempt will mean detention where?
Wala pa.
And it does not necessarily mean that it will be here? Thank you, Mr. Chair.
That is correct, yes. Now, can the Chair make a ruling?
Yes, please.
Salamat, maganda. Naintindihan mo ang sinasabi namin, Cassandra. In fact, binigyan ka ng pagkakataon na ni Congressman Roger Gutierrez na sagutin yung mga tanong na hindi naman incriminating. I am certain that your counsel has been giving you this advice na sabihin mo yung nakasulat dyan na you refuse to testify. Pero gaya ng binanggit namin kanina na mga jurisprudence, ay hindi ka pwedeng magtago dyan sa right, yung right against self-incrimination mo sa pagdinig na ito dahil pinapayagan ng desisyon ng Korte Suprema na ikaw ay i-compel na sumagot sa mga tanong. Dahil hindi ka nagko-cooperate dito sa pagdinig na ito, there is now a motion, upon the motion by Congressman Benny Abante to cite you again for contempt. And hearing no objections from the members of this committee, the chair rules
that you are cited in contempt. Any other motion?
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Congressman
Jones. Mr. Chair, may I respectfully request, Mr. Chair, I know for the several committee hearings that we've conducted, normally the lawyer sits at the back of the client. May I request, with all due respect to Attorney Topacio, to please sit behind Ms. Cassandra Ong.
Okay, Mitch, can you please provide another chair for the lawyer of Cassandra Ong?
Mr. Chair, may I make a manifestation?
Congresswoman Luistro.
I wish to believe that when an attorney is supposed to advise a client, he's supposed to talk to the client, let us say 5 minutes, 10 minutes. But if he does it in every question which is being propounded to the resource speaker, it seems to be he is supplying already the answer to the resource speaker. A situation which we do not allow here in the inquiry in aid of legislation. And I wish to manifest, Mr. Speaker, that every time a question is propounded to Cassandra Leong, Attorney Topacio whispers to the client. And I have no other reasonable conclusion except he is indeed supplying already the answer, far from advising a client.
Thank you, Congresswoman Luistro. Naintindihan mo ang sinabi ni Congresswoman Luistro?
Yes po.
Okay, so pwede ka nang sumagot ngayon sa mga tanong sa'yo. Please continue, Congressman Dan Fernandez.
Are you ready to answer?
Yes, yeah, second motion. Sorry. Yeah, correct. Okay, is there any motion?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For the second motion, Mr. Chairman, I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the duration in which until the committee report will be adopted in the plenary, Mr. Chairman. And it follows that the investigation will be terminated, Mr. Chairman.
There is a motion to detain her as long as this committee hearing of the Quadcom completes its investigation, which as of this time, as we speak, is still undetermined as to the number of days. So until we terminate, hanggang matapos itong committee hearing na to, you are cited in contempt and you will be detained as a penalty for violating Section 11 of our rules. Any second? Duly seconded. Any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Okay, Mr. Chairman.
Next motion.
Mr. Chairman, with that, Mr. Chairman, I move that since the congressional facility for detainees is too crowded, I move that Ms. Cassandra Ong will be detained in the Women's Correctional Center. So move, Mr. Chairman.
There is a motion to detain Cassandra Ong at the Women's Correctional Center located at
Mandaluyong.
It's a detention facility, Women's Correctional. Duly seconded. Any objections? Hearing none, the motion is approved.
Okay. Mr. Chair, may I continue?
Please proceed.
All right, since the Ms. Cassandra Ong will not answer, you want to answer?
Mr. Chair?
You don't want to answer. So, Mr. Altenco, I'll be asking you a question.
Mr. Chair, very short interjection.
Can we, what?
Very short only.
Okay, with the indulgence of Congressman Dan Fernandez, this is related to the
about Cassandra Ong.
Okay, this is related to the contempt.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Please proceed.
It is apparent to me that Ms. Cassandra Ong is turning emotional upon hearing the detention in the Women's Correctional in Mandaluyong. And you should really worry about that, because the facility is entirely different from the detention that you are experiencing here in Congress. I wish to ask, Mr. Chair, if Ms. Cassandra Ong is willing to avail of the executive session to give us the chance to reconsider the earlier contempt order, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Gusto mo ba mag-avail ng executive session na kung saan ay ikaw ay magko-cooperate sa aming committee sa investigation na ito?
Kasi baka you want to say something sa executive session, ibig sabihin, kami-kami lang. So, if you wanted to avail on that privilege, you can do so para hindi na didinig ng buong bayan. Are you willing to avail of that?
Attorney Topacio, this is your last warning. Please, you are coaching your client.
Yeah, please stop whispering, no? Please stop. And kasi I have to remind you as well, that this involves human trafficking. No bail yan. No bail. Sana tulungan mo gobyerno. Kasi sabi mo, Pilipina ka. Di ba? And I will be submitting all the documentary evidences in a while because you don't want to ano, you don't want to answer eh. But sana tulungan mo kami eh. Nakita mo yung mga namatay, mga tinorture, mga kapwa nating mga kababayan. Now, are you willing to avail of that privilege of having an executive session with all the members of this Quadcom? Yes or no? I did explain the executive session. It's a privilege. Tayo lang ang mag-uusap. Tayo lang. It's about, ano, Cassie. Ganito ka simple, Cassie. Listen, please. Stop whispering to her. Stop. Pagbihan natin siya mag-isip ng sarili niya. Malaki na si Cassie. She knows what to answer. And we will be helping you. Remember, when I told you, over the phone, we will help you. Just cooperate. Be truthful. Be honest. You are a Pilipina. Di ba? Maaring hindi ikaw ay kasalanan. Katulad ng tinext mo sa akin, ayaw mo maipit sa mga nag-uumpog ang malalaking batong yan. You tell us. Samahan mo kami. Tandaan mo lahat ng mga tao na kapaligid sa'yo. Ha? Meron mga sariling interes yan. You think about yourself. You think about your own interest. Yung mga nakapaligid sa'yo may sariling interes. We want to help you. Honestly, when you texted me, na sinabi mo sa akin na may nag-uumpog ang malaking bato, I really don't want to answer back. You know why? I want you to reveal that in here. But if you cannot reveal it right away, you talk to us. Tayo lang. Lalabas tayo dito. Pumunta tayo sa likod. Pag-usapan natin. Pero tumulong ka sa amin. Tumulong ka sa bayan. Nakita mo yung mga taong namatay. Di ba? So you can save yourself. Please. Please. Kapag pinabayaan mong ganito, sagot ka ng sagot ng ganyan, ikaw matitiyan dito. This can be used against you. I'm telling you, you're not answering rightly. Oh. Kaya, tulungan mo sa sarili mo. If you want to avail an executive session without anybody behind you or surrounds you, tayo lang, kami lang. You want?
Pwede pong pag-isipan.
Sige, but again, we will be warning you. Ha? The Filipino people are watching right now. And your answer to them is not acceptable. Maraming namatay. Maraming buhay na wala ng trabaho. You can still save yourself. I'm telling you. Mr. Chairman, for the meantime, let's give her a chance to think about it. And ako, honestly, I will help you. Kasi nung when we talk over the phone, sincerely, I know that you wanted to avail of that help. And we will, Cassie. We will help you.
Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chairman, before, siguro, let's give her a chance. Bigyan muna natin siya ng 2 minutes. Mag-isip lang siya.
Sige.
Pero please, Cassie, if you are about to think it over yourself, ikaw lang, huwag ka na magsama ng mga tao sa paligid mo. I'm telling you, their own interest is their priority, not yours. Can we ask Alteng?
Before that, there's a short interjection by Congressman Abante. And please, let this be the last interjection so that we can complete the interpellation of a member who has listed his name in the list of interpellators. Thank you, Congressman Abante.
Pwede bang, Cassandra? Pwede bang makinig ka lamang, no? I am willing to withdraw my motion or I will tell us, the chair, to withdraw this ruling kung willing ka na. Pag makinig ka kay Congressman Dan Fernandez, ginagawa mo ito hindi para sa amin, kundi para sa mamayang Pilipino. Please, tumabayag ka na sa executive session. Please.
Mr. Chair, the reserve speaker is asking for time for herself. And I think when she said that, it's incumbent upon everybody to respect that. So let her think by herself. Huwag na nating isama itong mga nakapaligot dito. Nako-confuse yung bata eh. She's still so young. 24 years old. Di ba? Accepting so many. Cassandra, we wanted to help you. Really. Honestly. Sir, can we proceed?
Please proceed.
Don't allow Cassandra na malapitan po ng ano. I mean, bigyan po natin ang pagkakataon yung sinabi niya na she wanted to think about it herself. Okay? Can you, yung picture number 1, pakikita lang po natin. Pick 1, pakita lang natin. Cassandra, yan. I want to show you, ano, para at least alam mo rin, Cassandra, that we have all the documents pertaining to the Whirlwind Corporation and the Lucky South 99. From 2022 up to present, executive assistant ka ng Whirlwind Corporation. And this was submitted sa PAGCOR. 2019, Lucky South 99, consultant ka na. 2023, nasa Lucky South 99 ka, outsourcing as authorized representative. And meron kang tinatawag noong 2021 up to present, yung Kape Forest. And this Kape Forest is very crucial to, Cassie. So we will be asking you sana din mamaya about this. But next picture, pakita po natin yung picture ng PIC 11. So sa PIC 11 po, picture 11, 11. Doon sa picture 11, hindi yan ang pick 11. Sa picture 11, meron dito kasi, ayan, yan is your application form mo, kasi you applied sa PAGOR. At pirma mo to, di ba, Catherine? Kasi, ano, yun yung pirma mo. Tama? Pirma mo to, di ba? At this was submitted to PAGOR. At nakalagay dito, I'm duly authorized to submit the application on behalf of the corporation, partnership, other business entity named as applicant. Okay? So, next picture. Picture 23. Picture 3. So being the authorized representative, ikaw ang binigyan ng karapatan kung sino man ang mga kasamahan mo doon to issue checks. Ayan, tama. And this one, sa Lucky South Outsourcing Incorporated, 11 November 29, 2023, nag-transmit ka by wire ng almost $200,000 doon sa PAGOR. Ito ay pagkatapos ng meeting nyo kay Altenco. And I will try to ask Mr. Altenco about this. And also, during the time of, that is, I think September 15, 2023, you issued also $100,000. Di ba? So, ito, ikaw rin na nagpadala. Altenco, Chairman, will you confirm that Ms. Cassandra Ong, together with Mr. Harry Roque, visited you in PAGOR? But before you answer that, I want to ask Cassandra, kasi si Attorney Harry Roque was telling us that he is your lawyer. Who is your lawyer? Si Topacio ba or si Harry Roque?
Sa Whirlwind lang po.
Sa Whirlwind lang siya lawyer. Dito sa project mo sa Congress, ang lawyer mo na ay siya na?
Attorney Topacio.
Okay, that's good. Thank you for that answer. Happy ako, nakadinig na ako ng sagot mula kay Cassie. Al, thank you. Will you confirm that you were able to talk to Cassie together with Attorney Harry Roque?
Yeah, Your Honor, yes. She went to the office together with, as I had narrated this before, together with Attorney Harry Roque sometime in July 2023.
So, no, July 2023, and after that, will you confirm also that she paid the amount that was due to that company, the Lucky South 99?
On that same day, so it was mali po yung, Your Honor, yung iba po yung deposit slip na pinakikita ninyo
yeah,
earlier.
Yeah, I know. Opo. These deposits are
on,
after.
Yun po yung succeeding deposit.
Yes, correct.
On that day, July 26, 2023, they made two payments on that day that we met.
Mm-hmm.
One in the amount of $50,000 paid in cash, and the other in the amount of $153,000.
So that is the first payment? Two?
First payment. So a total of $203,000 on that day that we met.
Okay. Will you confirm that, Cassandra, that you paid that? Don't be afraid. Huwag ka matakot. Basta makikooperate ka lang sa kongresong ito. We will not, ano, be adverse sa'yo.
Pakiulit po.
For the last time, I will not speak anymore. Cassandra, can you reply to what the query of this representation? Yeah, sige, go ahead.
Pakiulit.
Sige, go ahead.
Pakiulit po.
Ha?
Pakiulit po.
Pareho rin.
Pakiulit.
Pakiulit. Will you confirm that you were with Altenco during that time with Attorney Harry Roque and you paid those amount that he mentioned?
Yes po.
Yun. Thank you so much. And those two cash deposit slip, November and September 15, 2023, in the amount of $100,000 and $200,000, you also transmitted this amount.
Yes po.
Oh, yan. Thank you. Alam mo, makikipoperate naman talaga si Cassie eh. Ang problem lang, the people around, that's the problem that we are encountering. And basically, Cassandra, you are also the beneficial owner of the Whirlwind Corporation. Am I right?
Whirlwind lang po.
Yes, Whirlwind. You are the beneficial owner. And you have like 58% doon sa Whirlwind. So kanina, going back again, doon sa sinasabi namin that merong malalaking tao na nakapaligid sa... You want to have an executive session with that? Para at
I'm
least...
I'm still thinking pa po.
Ha?
I'm still thinking pa po.
You're still thinking?
Yes po. Thank
okay.
you.
Sige, punta na lang tayo doon sa Mr. Chairman. Kasi meron dito mga incorporators, sila... yung bagong mga directors, mga officials ng Lucky South 99 Outsourcing. We were not able to ask them in the last hearing. Andiyan sila Julian Linsangan, sila Chan, and sila Ong. Sinasabi nyo na that identity theft yung sa inyo. Di ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
At sinasabi nyo that si Cassandra Ong, nakausap nyo through Viber video. Am I right?
We don't know the apps that used by the Dan De La Cruz, Your Honor.
Sige. Well, the chairman have whispered sa akin that I have to wrap up. But this is very important, no? Yung sa tatlong yon. Kasi yung tatlo bang yon na kilala mo, yung tatlong incorporators na yan? Can you kindly stand up, Julian? Kilala mo ba kasi?
Hindi po, pero...
Pamilya?
Naka-video call ko yata.
Naka-video call mo sila?
Okay. I think one time through Dan.
And you were trying to tell us... no, you can sit down. Julian, ano ka eh? Legal researcher ka pala, no?
Yes, Your Honor.
Legal officer ka rin ng Mighty Corporation.
Before, Your Honor.
Yes, and legal consultant ka din ng Legendary Fireworks.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So in other words, I... you are all qualified to be a official of this corporation. Last question. Sige, last question ako. I'll be asking you about the itong tinatawag nating kay Marion Ryan Ong Chua. Meron ka bang pinurchase na manager's check?
Wala po,
2.6 million?
Wala po, Mr. Chair.
Sigurado ka, ha?
Yes po, Your Honor.
You're under oath?
Yes, Your Honor.
At pag napatunayan namin that you did, in the next hearing, we'll be citing you in contempt as well. Ha? And si Julian Linsangan, may alam ka ba sa Yes to Health Incorporated?
Pardon, Your Honor?
Yes to Health Incorporated.
No, Your Honor.
Wala kang alam?
Wala po.
Sa Puting Kahoy, sila ang Cavite. Ha?
No, Your Honor.
Na kung saan nakapag-issue ka ng check amounting to 16.7 million. You are under oath. Tanda mo yan, Julian.
No,
you are under oath. 16.7 million. Huwag ka magsisinungaling sa Kongresong ito and we will be citing you in contempt. Believe me.
Your Honor, I will check the transaction.
This is 16.7 million. Ang laki nito para makalimutan mo. Meron ba?
Ang natatanda ko po 16 million.
Sa iyong asawa, kay Rachel Ann Linsangan. Yes or no?
Your Honor, ang natatanda ko po sa transaction na yan, meron pong nabentang property na ako yung authorized representative, Your Honor.
Okay, sige. I'm telling you, ha? 16.7 million.
Yes, Your Honor. Yun po yung...
Ito ang sinasabi mo, benta ng lupa.
Yes, Your Honor.
Submit to us the deed of sale.
Yes, Your Honor.
Pertaining to that, ano?
Yes, Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, sino ang katransaction mo sa 16.7 million? Anong lupa? Saan?
Yun po sa...
Saan?
Yung sa binanggit niyo pong lugar, Your Honor, Puting Kahoy.
Saan lugar? Puting Kahoy. Gano'ng kalaki? Ilang square meter?
2,500 square meter,
Your Honor. 2,500 square meter? 16 points. How much per square meter?
It's 7,000, Your Honor.
7,000? Saan area yan?
Doon po sa Puting Kahoy, Your Honor.
Saan nga sa Puting Kahoy? Anong barangay?
Hindi ko po matandaan.
Alam natin ang assessment ng lupa dyan. Saan? Sa Silang?
I will submit the document, Your Honor.
Ang dami mong lupa?
No, Your Honor.
Para hindi mo malaman yung bentahan yun. You tell me, honestly, may bentahan ng lupa, wala?
Meron, Your Honor. Representative lang po ako, Your Honor.
Representative ka lang? O, so paano ka na-transfer ng 16.7 million?
No, Your Honor.
Sa Y2?
Hindi po.
Yes to Health?
Hindi po transfer, Your Honor.
Manager's check?
Wala pong Yes to Health pong alam, Your Honor. Pero meron akong alam na nabentang lupa, Your Honor.
Anong sinasabi mo restaurant? Wala akong sinasabi restaurant.
Yung Yes to Health, Your Honor.
So paano mo nalaman restaurant siya?
No,
I did not even mention that it is a restaurant. How did you know that it is a restaurant?
No, Your Honor, I said...
How did you know that it is a restaurant? I didn't even mention it.
I said yes. You said yes, Your Honor.
Sabi ko, Yes to Health. Paano mo nalaman restaurant?
No, wala po pinabanggit na restaurant, Your Honor.
Oh, Yes to Health. Okay. Alright. Submit to us.
Yes, Your Honor. I will submit the documents, Your Honor.
Deed of sale.
Yes, Your Honor.
Amounting
all documents, Your Honor.
Thank you so much. Mr. Chairman, I'll be yielding back. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Congressman Fernandez.